Much love to all.
On the 27th of April 2007, a new search involving some 20 investigators was launched at Van der Sloot's parents' home in Aruba. Dutch authorities searched the yard and surrounding area, using shovels and thin metal rods to probe the ground. A spokesman for the prosecutor's office, Vivian van der Biesen, stated, "The investigation has never stopped and the Dutch authorities are completely reviewing the case for new indications." A statement released directly from the prosecutor's office stated, "The team has indications that justify a more thorough search." Investigators did not comment on what prompted the new search, except that it was not related to Van der Sloot's book. On the 21st of November 2007, Van der Sloot and the Calpo brothers were rearrested in Arnhem and Aruba, respectively, for suspicion of involvement in voluntary manslaughter and causing serious bodily harm that resulted in the death of Natalie Holloway, because of what the Aruba prosecutor's office stated was new incriminating evidence related to Holloway's disappearance. Van der Sloot returned to Aruba on the 23rd of November, and a court hearing on the 26th of November ruled to continue his detention for 8 days. The Calpo brothers were released on the 1st of December. Van der Sloot was ordered released on the 7th of December. He was released without charge the same day. The father's involvement in the case. Paulus van der Sloot was arrested on the 22nd of June 2005 for questioning in Holloway's disappearance. He was ordered released on the 26th of June after 3 days of questioning. According to Aruba's chief prosecutor, one of the Calpo brothers told investigators that Paulus, who at the time was training to be a judge, advised his son that, without a body, the police would have no case. Beth Holloway pursued Van der Sloot's parents in the media circus on Aruba, which ensued after Natalie's disappearance. She stated that Paulus acknowledged that they could not control their son and had sent him to a psychiatrist. On the 10th of November 2005, Paulus won an unjust detention action against the Aruban government, clearing him as a suspect and allowing him to retain his government contract. Paulus van der Sloot then brought a second action, seeking monetary damages for himself and his family because of his false arrest. The action was initially successful, but the award of 40,000 Aruban florins, US$22,300, was reversed on appeal. The family's finances had become depleted by their legal expenses. In January 2007, Paulus found work as a managing partner at the law firm that had represented him. On the 24th of November 2008, Fox News's On the Record aired an interview with Joran van der Sloot in which he said that he sold Holloway into sexual slavery, receiving money both when Holloway was taken and, later, to keep quiet. He also alleged that he paid the Calpo brothers for their assistance, and that his father Paulus paid off two police officers who had learned that Holloway was taken to Venezuela. Van der Sloot later retracted the statements he had made in the interview. The show aired part of an audio recording provided by Van der Sloot, which he alleged was a phone conversation between himself and Paulus, in which Paulus displayed knowledge of his son's purported involvement in human trafficking. According to prosecutor Hans Moos, the other voice heard on the recording was not that of Paulus. The Dutch newspaper De Telegraaf reported that the father's voice was almost certainly that of Joran, trying to speak in a lower tone. On the 8th of January 2010, Paulus ended his partnership at the law firm where he had been working. On the 10th of February 2010, while playing tennis in Aruba, he died of a heart attack at age 57. Joran van der Sloot returned to Aruba soon afterward and took up gambling. His mother, Anita, later remarked that van der Sloot had severe mental problems and had blamed himself for his father's death. He had left for Aruba before she could have him involuntarily committed, leaving a note, "I'm gone, do not worry."
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.